everyone. Today is Monday. We are starting another school week at home. So I'm here at my house and you're there at your house. So yesterday was Sunday, April 19th. And so today, what comes after 19? 20. So today is Monday, April 20th. 2020 or 2020. So we have a lot of 20s in today's date. It's April 20th, 20. And here we have 2020. So today is Monday. Today is Monday all day long. All day long. Yesterday was Sunday. Tomorrow will be Tuesday. Oh, what fun. Woo! Oh, what fun. Woo! So we're still in the month of April. We have had some funny weather where I live in the month of April. We've had rain. We've had warm, sunny days. We even had some snowy days. Over the weekend, when I woke up, there was snow covering everything outside. And I thought, how funny that it's snowing in the spring. But that happens. This week, we also have a special day coming up called Earth Day. We have a friend in our class who has a birthday tomorrow. And then the next day is Earth Day. And then on Friday is Arbor Day, which is a day where we celebrate trees. Trees are very important to us. All right, so why don't we get started with today's book. And this is a special book that I had when I was a little girl. It's called Cats Know Best. And the cover's not there, you can't see, but if you open it up, you see lots of cats. And I love cats. I have a cat as a pet, and I just think cats are so fun and interesting. My sun is shining pretty bright, so I'm going to see if you can see a little bit better if I do this. Okay. Cats know the best places to be, where to stay warm, or keep cool, and where to have their kittens. Look where this cat had their kittens, inside a dresser. And if you look at this book, if you look carefully, you see lots of cats hiding on each page. Here's a cat hiding. Here are the kittens in the drawer. Here's a cat peeking out from under the bed. Cats know the best food, where the milk is the freshest. Looks like this cat is drinking milk right from the kitchen table. Or the mice the most plump. How to nurse their kittens. Cats know best how to keep clean. They groom themselves and their kittens. Do you know what groom means? That means that they clean themselves. Just like this little boy is cleaning himself in the bathtub. That's how we stay clean. Cats stay clean by licking their paws and using their paws to wipe their face and clean their fur. Helping each other keep tidy too. So here's a cat looking at his friend. Cats know the best feelings. They love to have a good fight, teasing and scrapping. Cats love to play. And caring for their kittens. There's a lot of cats on this page. Should we count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13 cats. Cats know the best games. They love to play Cat's Cradle. Cats love string. And to pretend not to know or to care. But they do. The end. I wonder how many cats are on this page. Should we count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 20, that's today's number. 20. All right, let's see. Before we do our song, I was going to read about two more birds from our bird book here. And these are two birds that I see in my yard very often. And you might see in your yard too, because they live in our continent, North America, kind of all over the country of the United States. And so these you might have seen in your yard. They're little brown birds. They're called Carolina Wrens. They like to be near people. Their loud, clear call, repeated throughout the day, sounds like tea kettle, tea kettle, tea kettle. Carolina Wrens eat mainly insects. Since they do not fly south for the winter, these birds living in the north may not make it if the winter is especially long and cold and food becomes scarce. So here's a Carolina Wren bringing an insect back to the babies. A Carolina Wren can be identified by the large white line above its eye and by its rust-colored back. So you see this line here? So if you're out bird watching and you see a brown bird with a white line over its eye, then you'll know it's a Carolina Wren. Did you know that Carolina Wrens sometimes build their nests in funny places? For example, you might find one in an open mailbox or in the pocket of a pair of pants hanging from a clothesline. Wrens may carry their short, rounded tail straight up, or they may tilt it in toward their head. Did you also know that dull colors help a nesting bird hide from predators? Both male and female wrens are dull in color, so they can take turns sitting on the eggs. A brightly colored male bird, like the cardinal, does not help the female keep the eggs warm. So you see how they're very similar in color to their nest. That way they can hide when they're sitting on their eggs. But these eggs have already hatched, huh? These babies are ready for some food from their parent. So those are Carolina Wrens. And they sound like this. Tea kettle, tea kettle, tea kettle. And this is another bird that we often see in our area. It's called an American Robin. American Robins are familiar orange-breasted birds. They make themselves at home on lawns and in gardens. There you may see them running along the ground for short distances. Often they will pause and cock their head to one side, looking for food. Then they will make a quick stab with their bill to pick up a worm or an insect. You may also see them picking up berries or fruits. Male robins have a black head and neck. Females and young birds are grayer. The young birds have black spots on their breast, like other members of the thrush family. So this is a male, this is an adult male, and this is a young bird. So you see the spots on his chest here, on his breast. Did you know young robins grow very fast? Just 14 days after hatching, they are nearly as large as their parents. Robins make nests out of twigs and grass held together with mud. If there's no mud nearby, they will make mud by filling their bill with dust and dipping it in water. It takes them about a week to make the nest. You see what color robin eggs are? They're very pretty blue. Baby robins, like other baby birds, cut their way out of their shell using a structure called an egg tooth. This tiny tooth on the tip of their bill soon falls off. The baby birds do not have feathers. To stay warm, they must be fed often. Both parents help to feed them. Look carefully at this little baby coming out. He's got a little sharp point on the top of his beak. That's called his egg tooth. And that helps him break through the egg so he can come out and start growing and becoming an adult bird. All right, so today we looked at the wren, Carolina Wren, and the American Robin. So if you go out in your yard today, it looks like a beautiful beautiful day, maybe look out for those two kinds of birds. All right, our song next in our songbook is, I need to find it. It's a silly song called Boom Boom Ain't It Great to Be Crazy. Okay. It goes like this. Boom boom, ain't it great to be crazy? Boom boom, ain't it great to be crazy? Giddy and foolish all day long. Boom boom, ain't it great to be crazy? Way down south where bananas grow, a flea stepped on an elephant's toe. The elephant cried with tears in his eyes, why don't you pick on someone your own size? Boom boom, ain't it great to be crazy? Boom boom, ain't it great to be crazy? Giddy and foolish all day long. Boom boom, ain't it great to be crazy? Late last night I had a real strange dream. Ate a 9-pound marshmallow mama gave me. When I woke up I knew something was wrong. I looked around, saw my pillow was gone. Uh-oh. Boom boom, ain't it great to be crazy? Boom boom, ain't it great to be crazy? Giddy and foolish all day long. Boom boom, ain't it great to be crazy? All right, well, I hope you have a wonderful day, and I will see you again soon. Happy Monday.